Hello everyone, this is Erlin from the Experience Research Lab. Today I'm going to show you how to transform a variable by replacing the missing values. Just for your information, that in the previous video on recoding a variable emp2 into a different variable emp2 trans, I mentioned that the value of 13 here is the mean that I obtained from a descriptive analysis conducted separately. But what if I don't want to conduct any separate analysis? Is it possible for me to replace the missing values here? Well, and the answer is definitely yes, because SPSS actually has several methods of replacing the missing values, and I'll show you them one by one. To start with, I'll click transform and click replace missing values. Because I want to replace the missing values in the number of employees, EMP2, I'll select the variable and click the arrow button and give a name to the new variable. So yes, this procedure will create a new variable instead of overwriting the existing variable. So the name for the new variable is EMP2_mean, and the method will be the series mean. The series mean refers to the mean of all values in this variable emp2, and the mean will be used to replace all missing values. And to apply the method, I'll click change and click OK. When I click OK, SPSS will display another window of statistics viewer showing me the title. Notes, there is no warning here, and results variable saying that SPSS has created a new variable emp2min. There are 927 missing values replaced, and in total there are 1822 of valid cases. If I click window, I can go back to my data editor and see the new variable here, emp2min. As you can see here, from case number 7 to case number 15, for example, which do not have values in EMP2, now have values of 13.13 in EMP2 mean. And yes, this value of 13 is actually rounded down from the mean. To replace the missing value with another method, I'll go back to transform and replace the missing values. I'll click this one and change the mean, the name with emp2 mean points, because now I want to replace the missing value with the mean of nearby points. So mean of nearby points refer to the mean of the surrounding valid values. So if I define the span of nearby points for with 2, for example, SPSS will take the values of 2 cases above the missing values and 2 other cases below the missing values, and then calculate the mean and use it to replace the missing values of this particular group only. So I'll click the change to apply the method and click OK again. Click window and go back to my data editor. So this is the second new variable. In cases number 7 to 15, you can see that instead of replacing the values, the missing values, with the mean 13.13, this method replaced the missing values with 17.75. I'll use the calculator to show you how it works. So the values of 2 cases above the mean are 10 and 11, and the values below the case missing values are 35 plus 15. The total is 71, and divided by 4, because there are 4 cases above and below the missing values, equals 17.75. So that's how it works with the method. If you take another example, cases number 18 to 20, you can calculate the mean points by adding 35 plus 15 plus 1 plus 1 equals 52, and then divided by 4 equals 13. So it is important to know that this method is very sensitive to the order of cases, because if the order is different, the mean point will be different as well. So the second method is by replacing the missing values with median of nearby points. The name is now EMP2 median points, and the method is median of nearby points. So with this method, instead of taking the mean of the nearby points, SPSS will take the median. For example, this group of missing values, the median will be 11 plus 15 equals 26 divided by 2 equals 13. Let's see if it is correct. I'll click change and then click OK. Click window, go back to data editor, and yes, the median points for this particular group of missing values is 13. And this median is used to replace the missing values in this particular group. While for the other groups of missing values, SPSS will take different values, 35, 15, and then 1 and 1, and then put them in order, and the median will be between 1 and 15, which is 16 divided by 2 equals 8. The fourth method is by replacing the missing values by linear interpolation. So I'll select the variable first and then change the name with interpolation. And the method with linear interpolation. So with this method, SPSS will take the last value before the missing value, and then the first value after the missing values, interpolate these two values, and use it to replace the missing values of this particular group. Again, this is very sensitive to the order of the cases. So I'll click change to apply the method and click OK. Click window and go back to the data editor. This is the new variable using interpolation. For cases number 7 to 15, you can see that the new value for each case is different, because for case number 7, the missing value is replaced with 13.4. Case number 8 with 15.8, number 9 with 18.2, and so on. While for the second group of missing values, case number 18 to 20, interpolating 15 and 1, the output will be 11.5, and then 8, and then 4.5. The last method of replacing the missing values in SPSS is by a linear trend point. So with this method, I'll just click the trend and then linear trend point. With this method, SPSS will regress the values of the variable and then use the predicted values to replace the missing values. I'll show you how it works. Click change to apply the method and then click OK to tell SPSS to replace the missing values with a linear trend at point. Click OK and click window and go back to the data editor. And this is the last variables created to replace the missing values in the EMP2. If you have a look here, case number 7 to case number 5, 15 I mean, the missing values are replaced with 2.32, 2.33, 0.34, 0.36, 37, 38, 39, 40, and 41. While for the next group of missing values, the new values for the new variable are 2.45, 46, and 47. If you want to change the label, you can click variable view and type the label here. For example, EMP to min, I will type as number of employees replaced, like in bracket, missing values replaced with min, and then type the label for other variables replaced with min points for EMP2 min points. And then number of employees missing values replaced with median points for EMP2 median points, and number of employees replaced with interpolated values, and for the last variable EMP2 trend, type a label with number of employees missing values replaced with trend, series trend. I'll go back to data view, and before I finish this video, I'll slow the sending and show you how the method of replacing the missing values with the trend works. So this is the first group of missing values. Two cases number 249 to case number 288. So the new values for this group of missing values are 2.32, 33, 34, 36, 37, 8, 9, 40, 41, 45, 46, 47, 51, 53, 55, 57, 59, 60, 61, 62, 63, 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 73, 74, 76, 77, 78, 84, 86, 88, 89, 90. 91, 92, 94, and 98. So they create a series. So after the case values of 2.98, the next value is 3.0. After, and then 3.0 all the way down, when there is another, when there are more missing values here, it will continue the series. After 4.0, is 4.02, 03, 11, 15, and so on. So this is a predicted values. So that's how you transform a variable by replacing the missing values or using different methods: series mean, mean of nearby points, median of nearby points, linear interpolation, and linear trend at points. For more insights into data, data entry, data transformation, and data analysis in SPSS, please subscribe, listen, and watch our content that is available in text, audio, and video format. That is for today, and thank you for being with me. See you next time on the next video. Cheers!